شديد العقاب. And whoever opposes Allah, meaning by opposing what Allah has legislated, and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, whoever opposes Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, for indeed Allah is severe in punishments. Is severe in punishments. Sheikh mentioned also the ayah 63 of Surah An-Nur. لا تجعلوا دعاء الرسول بينكم كدعاء بعضكم بعضا قد يعلم الله الذين يتسللون منكم لواذا فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. The portion of this ayah, فليحذر الذين يخالفون. Warn those who oppose his command, meaning the commands of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. Lest if they do that, if they oppose the command of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, a trial will befall them, or they be afflicted by a severe torment. As the Imam Ahmad رحمه الله تعالى, he says, والفتنة هنا الشرك. Fitna, he said, is shirk. Because a person, by disobeying the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he may fall into zayr, to deviate away from the path, فيهلك, and therefore be destroyed. نسأل الله السلام والعافية. Also in Surah An-Nisa, verse number 65, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. Nay, by your Lord, they will not believe until they make you, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a judge in all their affairs. All matters of disputes amongst them, they turn to you to judge. And as the ulama, they mention, in his lifetime, they should turn to him in person. After his death, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they take all matters of disputes to the sunnah. And therefore, they find no opposition whatsoever to that which you have decided and judged, but rather they comply and they submit willingly to your judgment and your rulings. Likewise, the Shaykh mentioned Surah Al-Ahzab amongst these proofs that obeying the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم is not an option, but is an obligation. Ayah 36 of Surah Al-Ahzab. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. And it's not befitting for a believing man or a believing woman that when Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم decreed upon a matter, that they will have a choice within themselves. They will have another opinion to the matter. And whoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has indeed gone astray. Clearly. Then he mentioned the ayah 164 of Surah Al-Imran. قال الله تعالى لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وَإِن كَانُوا مِن قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conferred upon the believers a great favor, since He has sent amongst them a messenger, calling them to apply His ayat, His, and to purify them, and to teach them the book and the hikmah. The ulama, they says here, the hikmah is the sunnah. Teach them the book and the sunnah, even though before that they were on a clear misguidance. He mentioned also the ayah 21 of Surah Al-Ahzab. قال الله تعالى لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. Indeed, you have in the Messenger of Allah the best example to be followed. For he who hopes in a meeting of Allah and the last day and remember Allah much. He mentioned also the ayah 52, or from the ayah 52 of Surah Ash-Shura, وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم. Verily you, Muhammad, guides by teaching and by conveying the message. هنا هداية الدلالة والبيان ليست هداية التوفيق. Verily you guide, meaning by teaching, by showing them the path of the truth from the path of falsehood. For indeed you guide to a straight path. And also the ayah 31 of Surah Al-Imran. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say to them, in this ayah that the ulama, they call it ayah al-imtihan wal-ikhtibar, the ayah of test for those who they say they love Allah. Say to them, if you love Allah, then follow me. If you truly love Allah, then follow me. Allah will love you and forgive your sins. Allah is Ghafoor Rahim. And lastly, from the proof that the Shaykh mentioned, is the ayah 80 of Surah An-Nisa. مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ تَوَلَّى فَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا. Whosoever obeyed the messenger has indeed obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obedience of the messenger is obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ وَأَمَّا مِنَ السُّنَّةِ فَالنُّصُوصُ أَيْضًا كَثِيرًا مِنْهَا. Shaykh says, as from the sunnah, after he mentioned these ayat from the Quran, says, now from the sunnah, likewise, the texts are many. That obeying the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not an option. It didn't left for us whether we obey or not, but rather is a command by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is an obligation. منها ما أخرج البخاري في الصحيح. First of all, is that which Imam al-Bukhari has collected in his Sahih al-Jami'. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray as you have seen me praying. And وهذا أمر منه. He says, this is an order from the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He says, pray. This is a verb of command. This is an order from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We don't pray whenever we want. And we don't pray as we want, in any way we want. We pray according to the Sunnah as an order. وأخرج مسلم في الصحيح أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لتأخذوا مناسككم أي عني مناسككم فإني لا أدري لعلي لا أحج بعد حجتي هذه. قال واللام لام الأمر أي لتأخذوا عني مناسك الحج. Likewise in the hadith, the long hadith, a portion of it that is collected by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, take from me. And this order, this lam, لِتَأْخُدُوا لَامُ الْأَمَرِ. The Prophet ﷺ, he gave an order that the rights of Hajj should be taken from him. The companions who were with him, they see what he did and they do. And those who come after them and after him, they should adhere to the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. You want to perform Hajj? It's not about just get a ticket and go there and come back with the name Hajji Fulan. And when they don't call him Hajji Fulan, get mad. He laba, got a port because Hajj is ibadah. And we're getting in close to the Hajj anyway. This is the seasons of Hajj. Alhamdulillah, Muslims, they will be leaving very soon. Some of them may be there already. Because as the ulama, they mention, if someone goes in Shawwal, in any day of Shawwal, with the intention of making Hajj and stay there, that's okay. If a person goes in any day of Shawwal with the intention of making Hajj and made Umrah and stay there, that he is mutamatta. Unless if he interrupted by going back to his country. So the Muslims, they be going from Shawwal on. Of course, those who can afford, because the more you stay, the more it's going to be, you know, you have to pay for that. Ala ayin, the Prophet ﷺ here, he ordered, he gave a command that the people should perform Hajj as he performed Hajj, according to his sunnah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وأخرج البخاري في الصحيح من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة إلا من أبى. Likewise in صحيح البخاري from the hadith of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, all of my ummah will enter al-Jannah except the one who refuses. قالوا يا رسول الله ومن يأبى. They said, O Messenger of Allah, who will refuse? Sheikh Abdullah says, أي أن هذا أمر لا يعقل من هذا الذي يأبى للجنة. He says, because this is something that doesn't even occur in the mind of a person. Really, someone will refuse the Jannah? Somebody doesn't want the Jannah? Somebody doesn't want to be in the Jannah? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. Whoever obeys me will enter al-Jannah. Whoever disobeys me has indeed refused the Jannah. That's how people refuse the Jannah, by disobeying the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, because there is no way to the Jannah except through this man, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, by following his guidance. But how are we going to follow his guidance if we don't know what it is? Gotta know what it is. Some people, they believe masakin, the Sufiya and the Khawarij and the many wicked sects, they presenting them bid'ah in the form of sunnah, and they think they are on the path of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they're gonna meet him on Yawm al-Qiyamah, they're gonna be with him in Jannah. But bid'ah does not get to the Jannah. Bid'ah does not lead to the Jannah. Bida leads the people far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الحافظ ابن حجر في الفتح: الموصوف بالإباء هو الامتناع. إن كان كافرا فهو لا يدخل الجنة أصلا, وإن كان مسلما فالمراد منعه من دخولها مع أول داخل إلا ما شاء الله تعالى. الحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني, as in فتح الباري, because he has explained صحيح البخاري, he explained to us this hadith. What does it mean, refuses? When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, all of my ummah will enter al-Jannah except the one who refuses. He explained to us how people refuse and abstain from Jannah. He said, if that person is a kafir, a disbeliever, would not enter al-Jannah, period. The disbeliever does not enter al-Jannah. But if a person is a Muslim, so what is it? What is intended here, that he would not be admitted to the Jannah with the first people to get into the Jannah at the first place, unless if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will. As you know, some of the people who died upon Islam, they may end up in a hellfire because of those major sins that they didn't repent from. As the aqeedah, the clear aqeedah and the sound aqeedah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that opposes the aqeedah of the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila and Ahlul Dalal, that the believer, the Muslim, who died upon a major sin that is less than shirk, will be under the mashi'ah of Allah on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Will be under the will of Allah on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Anyone who died upon a major sin other than shirk, lesser than shirk, then that person, he will be under the will of Allah. If Allah will to forgive them, they will be forgiven, and they will enter Jannah. Not like the Khawari, they say, no, he will be in hellfire forever, wa'yadu billah. But if Allah wish to punish them, they will be punished in the hellfire. But one thing is sure, they will not dwell there forever like the kuffar, disbelievers, and the hypocrites, and the munafiqeen, and the like. Now, قال الإمام الحافظ ابن حبان البستي إن هي الصحيح: طاعة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم هي الإنقياد لسنته, إلى أن قال: مع رفض قول كل من قال شيئا في دين الله عز وجل بخلافة سنته دون الاحتيال في دفع السنن بالتأويلات المضمحلة